I'm going to talk to you about the equalizer section of the Evo channel. The Evo channel possesses an extremely complete equalizer that is constituted of four parametric bands that go from 20 right through to 48 kHz, depending on the frequency of the sample. It also has a low and high shelf, as well as limitless low and high pass filters and their filter curves that are adjustable from 6 to 24 decibels per octave. An advantage of the Evo channel equalizer is its frequency analyzer. Here's a quick demonstration. I'm able to adjust the smoothness of the analyzer, which will allow me to either enter into the fine details or to look at it as a larger picture and potentially find frequencies that are overloaded. When working with the Evo channel, there are two possible modes. Either by using the buttons directly, like so, frequency, gain, EQ, bandwidth, or by clicking directly on the little spots that correspond to each band. With keyboard shortcuts, for example, we can sweep the frequency, or maintain the frequency, but adjust the gain, or do the exact opposite, sweep the frequency, but maintain the entry gain. It's really user-friendly and it's fast. At first I was generally more into buttons when using plugins, but here I've really become accustomed to using the curves, because with Gale we found that its function that we call S-curves make it very visual, very practical and really intuitive to use. More and more I find myself using the graphic, even more so when I'm using the analyzer. We can obtain results really quickly and very visually. We become used to listening to the sound without having to ask ourselves too many questions, making equalizations that are both spontaneous and intuitive. Generally speaking, the equalizer is very musical and very easy to use. Personally, what I really like about this equalizer is the fact that we're never limited to a maximum or minimum frequency within a band. So, if I want, I can use a low shelf from 4.5k right down to the bottom of the frequency spectrum, and sometimes that allows me to recuperate the tonal balance, something that's extremely important to do before correcting anything else. To be able to correct the tonal balance in the top or the bottom end, that's really important and something that I like a lot. Secondly, something we've not yet looked at is of course the use of automation on the parameters of each separate band. And finally, I must say that I particularly like the high and low pass filters that are perhaps the tools that I use the most when equalizing an instrument. They're particularly smooth when working at 6 decibels. I really appreciate this kind of filter. I use filters anyway, quite frequently, because I find them to be quite natural to equalization. So before touching any other parameter within the bands, I try to use filters or to use high or low shelves, which generally give a basic colour that's a lot more healthy than just going straight in and tweaking the cue at specific frequencies. I'll give you a little example of the 6 decibel per octave filter. So there you have it. A frequency to which I often find myself dropping the overheads in order to soften them and to remove their metallic side. A little demonstration with it on and then off. This incredibly smooth filter that's very nice to use. So to sum it up, this equalizer is an extremely powerful machine whose possibilities go beyond those of many other equalizers, in the sense that we have 4 full band parameters. That's to say that they sweep the entire spectrum of the sample's frequency. We have the high and low pass filters from 6 to 24 decibels per octave, as well as the 2 shelves that are the same, sweepable across the entire bandwidth, which makes it an extremely powerful tool.